أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم، حمدا لا يتناهى ملء السماوات السبع وملء الأرض السبع وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء الله من شيء بعد. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين، وصل على محمد في الآخرين، وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين، وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. جزاكم الله خير for coming. وبارك الله فيكم and ask Allah to make it in our balance in front of Allah عز وجل. And ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to accept our own good deeds and doing dua in this 10 days and doing good deeds in this 10 days and especially tonight. Because right now here is near to Isha, is exactly Fajr time there. Now is the Fajr time for that they are already upon Arafat, majority of them. Whole day here, which it is, was the night yesterday there. For Saudi Arabia, they were in Mina. For that they are moving from Fajr time going to Arafat. Some of them already from the night they moved to Arafat. By any way, short way is, there is between us and them 9 hours ahead. If you calculate it, you'll find the majority, or if you follow it in the news, you'll find them already upon Jabal, the mountain of Arafat, right now. For that from now, going on till tomorrow, Zuhr, they will stay in Arafat, according to our own time now here, talking about our time. From Al-Isha now, they already started, majority of them to be upon Arafat. They will stay according to their whole day, according to us here, will be from Isha now, going on till Zuhr of our own time. Zuhr of our own time. For that tahajjud at this night, doing some sadaqat, doing any good deeds, reading of the Quran, tasbih, especially the hadith itself saying la ilaha illallah wa subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wallahu akbar. Very highly recommended, very highly rewarded. Saying astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh, very highly rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any good deeds in these days, the most beloved amal to Allah, more than any other days, and more than greater good deeds in other days, including the days of Ramadan itself. For that tonight, one of the very important night, like in Ramadan, we usually give, remind the people about the Laylatul Qadr, 21st, 23rd, 25th, 27th, 29th, This is tonight. This night is one of the very important night for every single Muslim and Muslima to do tahajjud, to do qiyam al-layl, to do ibadat, to do turaqah for the sake of Allah, to say ask Allah forgiveness, to do some sadaqat, to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all good and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save you from all evil. Ameen. We're still with the Quran. And the last time I stopped with the hadith of Rasulullah in al-Bukhari, 4937, عن عائشة رضي الله عنها, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, الذي يقرأ القرآن وهو ماهر به مع السفرة الكرام البرة. Such person as recites the Quran and master it. Master it means it is easy for him, he knows how to recite it, out of training for himself and learning, and practicing a long time, it will become easy upon the tongue, become easy upon the throat, become easy to know makharij al-huruf, the tajweed, idgham, izhar, iqlab, ikhfa, and other things. Or that as long as mastering it by heart and mastering it by memory, by reading, will be with the angels, honorable and obedient in the heaven. Will be with the best. Will be with the angels. But not only that. والذي يقرأ القرآن وهو يتتعتع فيه وهو يتتعتع فيه وهو عليه شاق له أجران، أي أجر على تلاوته وأجر على تتعتعش المشقة. And such a person exerts himself to learn the Quran by heart. a person he try, and this is halaqa about steps and inshallah the rules of memorizing Quran, the ways of memorizing Quran, methods of memorizing Quran, etiquette, the point. Some of it actually it is a condition to memorize Quran. Means in summary how to make it easy for yourself to memorize the Quran from beginning till the end. What should I do to memorize the Quran? For that whoever even facing difficulties of memorizing Quran, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, facing difficulties to memorize by heart and facing difficulty even to recite it with a great difficulty will have double reward. The one who is easy for him and mastering it, he is will be with the angels, with the honorable people, with the النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا, with all of the good people and the pious people, righteous people, and this is the best company you will have. If suppose I'm still having some difficulties and hard for me to read, and I'm trying still to connect the letters, some of the mistakes here and there, but I'm trying to improve myself, he will have a double reward. One reward for his reading, and the other reward for the difficulties he is facing. And I remember the last time also saying about the reading, this time about the memorizing. But the last time I said there is a so easy way to read the Quran every month one time. Remember it when I said that if you read the Quran every prayer just 4 pages, before the prayer or after the prayer, for every single prayer 4 pages, you want to divide it 2 before the prayer or 2 after the prayer, 4 before the prayer, 4 after the prayer, whatever, but 4 multiplied by 5 daily prayer, every prayer 4 multiplied by 5 daily prayer, multiplied by 30 day, which it is, or 31 day, which it is a month, this will be almost more than 600 pages, which it is the whole Quran. Means easy, if you read, able Allah make it easy for you to read, only just 4 pages, every prayer, with a total 20 pages a day, every month, you will finish the whole Quran, reading. We'll come to the rules and the steps and the point of memorizing, inshallah. And also make it easy for yourself, have one of the Quran with you and make a sign. Usually there is some rope, you put it in where you stop. In order to remember, I stop here, then I have to go on. But if we go to where I stopped the last time, that your level in al-Jannah and the hereafter will be according to how many ayat you memorize. More ayat memorizing, more higher level in al-Jannah. Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in al-Tirmizi, يُقَالُ لِصَاحِبِ الْقُرْآنِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ will be said to the one who is company the Quran, who is a friend to the Quran at the day of judgment, اِقْرَأْ وَارْتَقِي وَرَتِّلْ, read and be in a higher level and have higher degrees in al-Jannah, كَمَا كُنْتَ تُرَتِّلُ فِي الدُّنْيَا, as you used to recite it in dunya, فَإِنَّ مَنْزِلَتَكَ عِنْدَ آخِرِ آيَةٍ تَقْرَوْهَا, your degree, your high level will be according to how many ayah you are memorizing. How was Salaf al-Salih and al-Sahaba of Rasulullah with the Quran? Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab, كان لا يملك دمعه عند قراءة القرآن الكريم. He used not be able to control his tears, crying, because of understanding what the meaning of it. He used to not to be able to control his tears when he recited the Quran. وعن عبد الله بن شداد, he said, سمعت نشيد عمر بن الخطاب وأنا في آخر الصفوف في صلاة الصبح. I heard the crying of سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب in صلاة الفجر while he is reciting. Now I was at the end of the last صف. يقرأ في سورة يوسف, he was reciting سورة يوسف, آية number 86. قال إنما أشكو بثي وحزني إلى الله. I only complain of my grief and my sorrow to Allah alone. And he was crying. وسمع عمر بن الخطاب رجلا يتهجد في الليل ويقرأ سورة الطور. فلما بلغ إلى قول الله تعالى في سورة الطور, إن عذاب ربك لواقع ما له من دافع. قال عمر, قسم ورب الكعبة حقا. ثم رجع إلى منزله فمرض شهرا يعوده الناس لا يدرون ما مرضه. That it was Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab Usually he used to check the يعني the community what it is, if they need something, then he heard somebody doing tahajjud at the night and reciting an ayah in Surah At-Tur. When he came to Surah At-Tur, Surah number 52, ayah number 7 and 8, إِنَّ عَذَابَ رَبِّكَ لَوَاقِعٌ. Verily and truly, the torment of your Lord will surely come to pass, will happen. The torment and the azab for those who disobey will happen. And there is none that can avert it. Nobody can avoid it. Nobody can save himself from it except if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save him. When he heard that, he cried. He used to fear Allah a lot, Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab. When he heard this ayah, he cried a lot. And he said, by Allah, Allah swear, because this ayah is a swear from Allah. He said, by the Lord of al-Ka'bah, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is the truth. And we ask Allah, save us, say ameen. Then he get back to his house and he gets sick. 1 month, the people visiting him doesn't know what happened to him. What is Al-Quran about? Al-Quran يتعامل مع كل ما يختص بني آدم. Quran deals with all the subjects which concern the human being. Quran deals with all kind and different subjects which deal with the human being. Like what? Like the wisdom, الحكمة, like العقيدة, doctrine, العبادات, the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like the spiritual life, المعاملات, transactions, like the law. Quran and Islam covers your life completely from the minute you born till the minute you die. Actually, the right way from the time before you born, all of your life, Islam and Quran covering it, until after you die, not only die, after you die, because before you born, order the parent what they should do for you. And even after you die, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order us what should we do to the one who die. For that the Islam and the Quran covering all of the life. Before you born, during your life, all of it, and after. There is not even a single action or a single second in your life, Quran or Islam does not cover it. It covers, but maybe you know it, maybe you don't know it. But we can summary the giving some definition or relations of the Quran or the explanations of the Quran, the law of the Quran, the law of Islam deals about 3 points. Your relation with your Lord, your relation with the people around you, your relation with your own. 3 points. Quran and Islam and Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whole Islam in total, deals with the 3 points. Your relation with Allah means how to worship Him. What is the way to worship? Like Salah. How to do and what to do and what the time of it. Quran explains that and Sunnah of Rasulullah. Islam explains your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your relation with others around you. What is their right upon you and what's your right upon them? What is their right upon you? And what's your right upon them? Quran deals with that also. The third relation, your relation with your own self, which it is al-halal and al-haram. في المأكل والمشرب والملبس والماليات. The halal and haram, and whatever you eat, whatever you drink, whatever you wear, the clothes and everything, and whatever deal with transaction, money. Halal and haram in eating, halal and haram in drinking, halal and haram in whatever you wear. Like for the men, gold is forbidden and silver is silk is forbidden for the men. This is about whatever you wear. And also for the money, for that the Quran and the Islam deals with 3 points. Your relation with Allah, how to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and worship Him alone and all the tawheed. Your relation with the other people, what is the right upon you, what is your right upon them. Your relation with your own self, which it is, what is halal and haram in this 4, eating, drinking, wearing, and dressing, and the money. Al-Quran provides guideline and detailed teachings for just society, for the proper human conduct, for the proper human community, and equitable economic system. The economic system, Islamic economic system, is in Quran, but the problem Muslim does not apply. We take all kind of system from everywhere and we're leaving the system of the Islam. Now we will move to the main point of our halaqah, What is the steps of memorizing Quran? What you want to name it rules? What is the rules of memorizing Quran? What is the ways of memorizing Quran? Methods, easy methods of memorizing Quran, etiquette, adab, point. Some of it actually is a conditions. Condition with another way, how I memorize Quran. Or what should I do in order to make it easy for myself to memorize Quran? Number one, because Allah mentioned in Quran al-Kareem. In Surah Al-Qamar, Surah number 54, listen carefully, Surah Al-Qamar, Surah number 54, Ayah number 17, and Ayah number 22, and Ayah number 32, and Ayah number 40, four times. Surah Al-Qamar, Surah number 54, Ayah number 17, Ayah number 22, Ayah number 32, Ayah number 40, Allah repeating four times to you, saying, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرِ Second time, Allah say, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرِ Third time, Allah say, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرِ The fourth time, Allah say, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرِ And we have indeed made, Allah say, We have indeed made the Quran easy to understand and easy to remember. Allah make it easy to understand and easy to remember. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, then, is there anyone who will remember? Is there anyone who receive admonition? Is there anyone who want to really to memorize? Allah saying that to you from above seven heaven, in the best book in the whole earth, the Quran al-Kareem, talking to every single one of us, saying, is there anyone who want to memorize? I make it easy. Is there anyone who want? But there is a steps for that. There is some ways, there is some rules, etiquettes. Number one, and very important, contain two things. Sincerely to Allah with a sabr. If you miss these two, you will never. You are hurry, and you want to have the whole Quran in a few minutes, impossible. You have to be sincerely for the sake of Allah. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّةِ And this is the secret of memorizing the Quran. Sincerity to Allah with sabr, patience. If you are not patient, you will never. Quran need you to be so patient. Never feel give up. Never feel, oh, I already tried many times that ayah and I cannot. And I already tried many times that surah. No. And actually, subhanAllah, in order to know, for a glad tiding and this from Allah, more hardship you are facing for memorizing, more reward you will have. Because more repeating you have, more reward. Imagine somebody memorized only in three times and somebody memorized after 300 times. Which have more reward? The one who memorized in 300 times. For that, if it is hard for you, don't think that, oh, يعني خلص, I'm not able. No, 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 no. There is nothing it's in him not able. Some people I know, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Allah gives them the barakah of memorizing while they are more than 50 years old. And mashallah, laqata illa billah, memorized very well. Used to lead after 55 years old or more, lead the Taraweeh, memorizing the whole Quran from by heart. For that, what it is? Number one, very important, 2 point. Ikhlas niyyah, have a sincerity intention for the sake of Allah. And you will be tested in your intention. Allah will test you. Because sometimes you will think that your intention for the sake of Allah, while it is not. While it is not. For that, you will be tested. Is it really for Allah or not? Then this test, the result of it will be either for you or against you. And the day of judgment, Ya Allah, I did it for you. Allah will say, no, you are a liar. It was a test and this test was for your intention and it was not. Number two is it, in the same one, which it is sabr. This is the secret of opening the gates of Rahman, opening the gates of memorizing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being sabr, patient, and at the same time, sincerely to Allah. With it also, sabr, mukhlis, sabr, patience, ikhlas, sincerity, and also truthfulness. Being truthful that really you want it, have a strong will to have. Ibtigha'a mardatillah, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to have al-jannah. Whoever memorizing, as Rasulullah said, I didn't bring it. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said it, ليجاري به العلماء أو ليماري به السفهاء أو ليفاخر به الناس Whoever try to have the knowledge, and the best knowledge is the Quran, in order to be in between the ulama as a alim, in between the safih, the foolish people, something big, for show off, for boastful, for getting fame, for getting something like that, will never, Allah will never give it to somebody like that. Also for worldly life, some position, some job, something like that, any worldly life benefit, they will never. Must be sincerely for Allah Azza wa Jal, must be with the sabr, and ask Allah give us sincerity, ask Allah give us sabr, and must be truthfulness, sadq. Truthfulness, yes, really you want, and have a very strong will to memorize. At the same time, don't think that it will come in 1 second. No, you have to struggle, and you have to do some effort. And the result is, the reward is al-Jannah. But for whosoever do that without sincerity, for the sake of dunya, for the sake of money, for the sake of being famous, for the sake of so and so and so, anything other than Allah will never be accepted. Must be only for Allah Azza wa Jalla. Second one of the rules and the etiquette and the steps of memorizing Quran, better, and I'm saying it clearly, better to be while you are young. But do I already lost, if I'm now 40, 50, 60, lost the chance? No. But we're saying only better because التعليم في الصغر كالنقش على الحجر. Teaching and memorizing while you are very young, like digging in a stone. Digging in a stone to stay forever will never go away. You get my point? Learning while you are young, stay in a memory for a very long time. But is it mean that now I cannot? No. Give you the best example. Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they memorize, a lot of them while they are very old. A lot of the Sahaba, because they become Muslim while they are old. Right or wrong? For that they memorize the Quran, majority of them at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, especially the early time of it, that while they are very old, for that no any bad thinking, things that خلاص, already the train already passed. No. There is nothing the same, the train already passed. Quran will be with you as long as you will be with it. Remember that rule also. Quran will be with you as long as you will be with it. Also, Quran will leave you when you leave it. Quran will leave you when you leave it. Memorize any surah, Baqarah. And very, very well. And get busy. You didn't repeat it for a while. Believe me. If you start reading, you'll have a lot of mistakes as if you never memorize it. You leave the Quran, Quran will leave you. Including the recitation, even reading. If you leave the reading for a while, I know that of the teaching of our kids. When they absent for a while, then they come back, believe me, as if they have to start from beginning, from zero. Why? Quran will leave you when you leave it. Quran will stay with you. Rasulullah said it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This Quran will be easy to be, go away from your mind when you leave it. يتفلت كما يتفلت البعير من عقاله. Imagine that a camel was tied. As long as it's tied, it will be staying there. Just the rope will be losing, you'll run away. The camel will run away. This is the same. Tightening of the camel is repeating of the Quran. For that here, while you are young, sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the sabr and truthfulness, and also why it is young, because usually the young one in most of the time does not have a lot of problems and does not, his mind is not so busy like the old ones. The one in 30 and 40 and 50 with the job and with the family and with the business and with the so many things, everybody knows, everybody understands what I mean exactly. This is, it makes the mind less in, it is a part in the brain. This part, if have nothing in it except only memorizing, it will like the copy machine. Copy machine will write away copy. But if it is contain more than one thing, it will be weak. And it will not get any one of the things. Again, there is a center in the brain. That center is the memory. Like the memory of the computer. If this center busy with more than one thing, will never catch any. and if the catch will be part from here, part according to whatever, it need only one thing. If you can make your mind does not be busy with anything, and the memorize, you will memorize easy, and it will stuck. But if your mind while you are reading busy with many other things, it's an important الشعور في العربي. I don't know the names exactly in English, but there is a main place for memorizing in the brain. That one, if it's not busy with too many things, it will catch like the copy machine exactly. And we know very well one of the علماء of the مذاهب, I think الإمام الشافعي, if it was a book like that, he used to put his hand over one page in order for him, when he sees the other one, as if it's a copy machine, it goes right away to his mind. If he looked to the other page while he is memorizing, maybe some of the words from the other page will catch with it. For that, he usually come cover it with some of his clothes in order to see one page. Only then it will be خلاص كوبيت, finished. A lot of people till today the same. A lot of the people till today, you will find them when they are saying that about the numbers and about the names and about the ayat of the Quran and hadith of Rasulullah, and where it is just they read it one time, it will be stuck in their mind. But this is a need, a power from you to concentrate. Make your mind only concentrating in memorizing. Do not put yourself while you are reading about the food, while you are reading about the business, while you are reading where I'm going after that, while you're reading what's my day, what will I do today. No. More than one thing in your mind, it makes a memory of catching the Quran very weak. Cannot catch very well. For that, the young one, usually, in most of the time, except if he is busy also with the playing. And one of the things for the kids, never make him memorize while a lot of toys around him. And this calamity of the computers in his hand, and in front of him, and this television on the right, and there is internet on the left, and behind him some other kids playing. Subhanallah, he will never memorize nothing. Not only with the kids, with our own self also. No. Concentrate in one. For that, whoever have a strong will and have also truthfulness, and he concentrate and he have a very strong wish that I want to memorize to please Allah Azza wa Jal sincerely for Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, he will do. Doesn't matter how old are you. Doesn't matter how old are you. One of the rules and the etiquettes and the adab and the steps of memorizing the Quran also, other than what I mentioned, اختيار الوقت المناسب, choosing the best time. For that, choosing the best time, and especially the last third part of the night and al-fajr and after al-fajr, this is the best of the time. Especially if you're taking, after you're taking a rest and you're sleeping, then you wake up for fajr prayers and you memorize the Quran, this is the time of barakah. Time of the blessings. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say hadith sahih, Burika li ummati fi bukuriha. The early time of the day of my ummah is blessed. And really you will feel that. Really, if you want even to study tafsir al-Quran or any study, good studying, then that time is the best of the time. For that, all the schools, usually their timing of teaching is very early time, right? 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock. You will never find a school starting after 1 o'clock. Nothing like that. Majority of them, majority, I'm saying majority because some circumstances that there is no space and this and that, but this is some conditions they are not able. But if they have the chance, usually in whole world, schools start very early because this is the brain is waking up. Brain is fresh. Brain is not busy. Brain is not tired. Body also is not tired. Imagine yourself early morning after good sleeping, 8 hours at least, and waking up at the early morning and see, look to yourself at the same day after a lot of effort you are doing and exhausted, look to yourself at the end of the day, which part of the day you will be able to memorize, no any doubt, at the early morning. After being exhausted and very tired and very busy with many things, also as your body physically get tired, your brain also get tired. Also, as your body get also old, your brain with the time get old. For that, from a time to a time, from age to age, because some of the people used to before memorizing very well and very easy. When they get old, they want themselves to be the same. No. No. This is a time was your youth time. and you used to read it one time, خلاص الحمد لله رب العالمين. Now, when you get older, you need at least double or triple or more and more and more. For that, choosing the timing is the best of memorizing the Quran. One of the rules also of memorizing the Quran, اختيار, not the time only, the place. Place of barakah is, masajid. Masjid. But with the conditions. Don't come to the masjid and raise your voice, whole neighbor hear you, and the people around you cannot pray, and the one who is also want to memorize somebody else on there, no. If you are alone, no problem. Raise your voice as you like. Actually, raising the voice is one of the rules also, but with the conditions of it. For that, choosing the place. Suppose I'm not able to go to the masjid far away from me, because especially in the West here, very far sometimes, 25 minutes and 1 hour for some people, some other people, some other states, more than 1 hour actually. For that, choose the place in your house which does not contain a lot of things to attract you far away from memorizing. As I said with the kids, if there is in front of you internet, and the other side there is television, and the third side there is a telephone, and this is ringing, and this is doing music, and this is doing so on, subhanAllah, impossible to memorize anything. For that, you have to also, if the walls around you contain a lot of things also, while you are memorizing, your eyes will attract you, these things will attract your eyes to it. Some of the pictures, some of the colors, some of the so and so. This is, if it is a simple and humble place, no any net, TV, games also. Even the game in front of you are not playing with it, but it is just in front of you. It's a problem also. Because still your memory will and you will be attracted to it every while. Oh, where I stop with it? What I did last time? All of this will cut off the memorizing. If there is nothing come with the memorizing, will be memorizing only. But what you are memorizing, then the telephone ring. Then you answer it. While you are memorizing, the door knocked. Then you answer it. While you are memorizing, the internet stopped. Then you have to fix it. Then while you are memorizing, the other game has already started. Then you have to, oh, subhanAllah, this is impossible to memorize with that. For that need you to be far from all the things will attract you. In a place does not contain that. And if it is in masjid, not raising your voice upon the people who pray. Also suppose at the time of i'tikaf, like in Ramadan, I was facing some of the problem with some of the brothers also. Raising their voice so loud, no, should not. Because there is some other one to sleep going to their job tomorrow. Or that you can read silently in your brain. Also some other one to read like you. If I imagine that in the masjid, 10 people, and everyone will want to, what is that? It will be like a honeybee's farm. No. For that it is raising your voice if you are alone. One of the rules also, as I said, that to write, to recite the Quran with a voice, to hear it without disturbing others. And while you are memorizing, try to see, coming also one of the steps, on a one hand of a sheikh who already learned from others. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I will come to this point, but it is coming in the way. Rasulullah learned from Jibreel. And the Sahaba learned from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then the Tabi'een learned from Sahaba. That means it is with this way. Somebody must learn from somebody before, then he teaches on after. If you try to open the Quran by your own self and you read, you will do a lot of mistakes. Because some of it is sama'i. Means you have to hear it only. Example of that. And coming to later about that point. Alif Lam Mim contain Alif Lam Mim, right? Alam Nashrah Alam Alif Lam Mim. How you know that this is Alif Lam Mim and this is Alam? Only by hearing. Nothing else. Alam contain Alif and Lam and Mim. Alif Lam Mim, it is Alif and Lam and Mim. At beginning of Al-Baqarah, what it is? Answer me. Beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah, Alif Lam Mim. Beginning of Surah Al-Sharh, Alam Nashrah. Even it is the same letters. Same way of writing. The only way different between this and that, Rasulullah recite this way and they hear him for that the Quran by hearing, not only by reading. As I told you before, begin of Surah Maryam, Kaf, Ha, Ya, Ayn, Sad. This is connected in the Mus'haf. If by your own self you'll say Ka, Ha, Ya, As, or whatever Allah knows how you'll say it, it's connected. How you know that it is disconnected? Kaf as a kaf, Ha itself, Ya alone, Ayn by itself, and Sad only by hearing. For that, here we are saying that reciting is a good way. With hear yourself, it will make the memo, it will make the Quran, whatever you memorize, fixed in your memory. And especially if your tongue get used to it, it will be helping you to memorize. While you are reciting, and you hear your own self, two things will never obey you if you make mistake. Your brain and your tongue and ear. Tongue while you're reciting, and your brain will feel there is some, if you miss something, some part of the ayah or one word of the ayah, after getting used to reciting and to reading and come to a level of memorizing, a good level of it, then later if you have a mistake, you will feel it. Like, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Iyaka Na'budu. There is some mistakes here, normally you will feel it, no. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, ha? Malik Yawm al-Din. Then, Iyaka Na'budu. If you come to a level of memorizing, good level, then you will feel that there is some mistake. For that good recitation, Qira'a Mujawwada, with the learning of the Tajweed of the Qur'an al-Kareem, because wrong to memorize the Qur'an. Then, thinking, and a lot of Huffaz, they do this mistake. He memorized, doesn't matter right or wrong, then thinking later I will correct my tajweed. No, you have to learn tajweed while you are memorizing. Or better, before you memorize it. Again, a lot of mistakes happen with a lot of the Huffaz of the Quran al-Kareem. They say, let me memorize. When I finish, then I'll go to another sheikh or the same sheikh to correct my tajweed or my pronunciation. Completely wrong. With whatever you memorize and the mistakes you have will stuck in your mind forever. Very hardly to change it. Very hardly. Second thing, if you do not have a sheikh, and they will come to this point later, you will do mistakes while you think that you are doing right. You will do mistakes, commit mistakes while you are thinking that you are doing right. For that, learn the tajweed, apply it. I know it will be a little bit more difficult, but better this way. This is the best way, rules and the best way to memorize, complete, and perfect, and pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and khalas, one time and finished. But saying to yourself that I will memorize first, then after that I will go correct my tajweed, a lot of people say do that, then he still has a mistake, and he does not correct nothing. At the time of memorizing, step by step, learn, and tajweed is so easy, but need only just to hear it. Tajweed also, which it is the rules and the grammar of reciting the Quran. Tajweed is grammar of reciting the Quran. Cannot be by reading. You will read al-idgham, al-izhar, al-iqlab, al-ikhfa, al-mad al-tabi'i, al-mad al-'ard, al-mad al-muttasil, al-mad al-munfasil. You don't know what is that. It must be somebody saying how al-idgham, ma-ya, noon and ya, when the ya come after the noon sakin, this is will be join the noon with the ya together and named idgham. How you say it? This is the most important. Ma-ya. Did you see this noise? This noise coming from the nose? Ma-ya. This is idgham. For that, rules of grammar of the tajweed of the Quran need to hear it. Then you try to say it. And do not depend upon your own self of saying, because sometimes you will pronounce it wrong, and especially the letter, makharaj al-huruf, hamza, ha, ayn, ha, kha. These five letters, a lot of people they pronounce it wrong. Completely wrong. Hamza, ha, ayn, they say ayn, a lot of people. عين غين they say gain, حا they say ها, خا they say كا. Completely wrong. For that very important to somebody hear you, then he will correct. Because while you are reading by your own self, and this is the benefit of حلقات of reciting of the Quran in المساجد, and there is hadith of Rasulullah about it, because some people in some madhahib thinking that oh it should not be. No. It is hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم مجتمع قوم في بيت من بيوت الله يتلون كتاب الله as long as for study. and is not for ibadah as a kind of ibadah. Even if it is continuously, we ask Allah bless. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept it. This hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, any people gather themselves in a house of Allah, yatluna is a plural. Means they are reciting. It's one of the brothers saying that, oh, must be individual. No, where is in the hadith saying that individual? Saying yatluna is a plural. Means even together. For that this is one of the benefit of learning of the Quran al-Kareem. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, hadith in Bukhari, لَيْسَ مِنَّا مَنْ لَمْ يَتَغَنَّ بِالْقُرْآنِ. Not one of us, the one who does not know how to beautify the Quran by his voice and by the rules. يَتَغَنَّ actually means beautified. How you beautify? Not according to your own mind. Not according to my mind. There's the rules, which it is named, تَجْوِيد. أبو هلال العسكري he said ينبغي للدارس أن يرفع صوته في درسه حتى يسمع نفسه فإنما سمعته الأذن رسخ في القلب. أبو هلال العسكري saying that for everyone who tried to study, he should make study Quran, study for other things, he should raise his voice little bit to make himself hear himself, hear his voice. Because of whatever your ear hear from you, it will stain your heart. Whatever comes out from the tongue goes to your ear, it will stain your in your heart. For that very important to, with the condition saying that, without insulting anybody around you, without anointing anyone around you, somebody memorizing, let him to memorize, lower your voice. Inshallah, the next time we'll go on with some of the rules of memorizing the Quran, which it is try to memorize in one kind of Quran. There is some of the masahif small, some is medium, some is big, some small, some medium, some is big. Some of it, the lines calculated 13 lines, some of it 14 lines, some of it 15 lines. If you move from one to another one, and one time, any mushaf in your way, you will take it. No. Keep yourself, all of your life, in one. This will help you a lot. Will help you a lot. Teach your kids and teach everybody around you and your own self. You want to memorize? Start with one and keep yourself in that one. Look to all. I'm not recommending anyone, but there is the Mus'haf of Saudi Arabia, the one printed there and have 15 line, I think. And every beginning of every page have beginning of the ayah. End of every page, end of ayah. Every single page. The new printed now, last few years, is starting with the ayah, ending with the end of the ayah. And this is very good. But suppose you like some other things, some people they are not able to read that kind, they read the Kufi, Masri, or whatever it is, subhanAllah, no problem with that at all. But I am saying that if you start with one and we'll go in with the details of that one next time, inshallah, keep yourself in that one. Sometime reading in the small, and then moving to the old one, the big one, then moving to the one 13 line, then moving to the one 14 line, moving to the one who have 9 line, then moving to the one 15 line, this will disturb you completely. You will never memorize. And if you memorize, it will not be good like somebody is memorizing from only one. Inshallah, we'll move to other rules also. Then correcting your ayat, connect the ayat with each other, from ayat to another ayat, in these two ayat, with the one before, then one with after, and going on with these rules and steps and regulations and the conditions, inshallah. The next time, Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana, Allahumma kaffir anna sayyatina, Allahumma tawaffana ma'al abrar, Allahumma a'inna ala dhikrik wa shukrik wa husn ibadatik, wa taqabbal minna ya hayu ya qayyum ya arhamar rahimin, waj'alha fi mizani hasanatina ya hayu ya qayyum ya arhamar rahimin, wahdina wahdibina waj'alna sawan liman ihtada, Allahumma inna nasaluka al-huda wa al-tuqa wa al-afafa wa al-ghina, waghnina bihalalika an haramik wa bita'atika an ma'asiyatik. اللهم اغفر لوالدينا وارحمهما كما ربيانا صغارا. اللهم اغفر لوالدينا وارحمهما كما ربيانا صغارا. اللهم اغفر لوالدينا وارحمهما كما ربيانا صغارا. اللهم اجعلنا بارين بهم يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم ارزقنا بالبر بهم وارزق ابناءنا البر بنا يا ذا الجلال والاكرام. اللهم قوي ايماننا وارفع درجاتنا وتقبل صلاتنا واغفر خطيئاتنا وارزقنا الاخلاص في القول والعمل. اللهم ارزقنا الاخلاص في القول والعمل. اللهم ارزقنا الاخلاص في القول والعمل. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الفردوس الأعلى في الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل، ونعوذ بك اللهم من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الفردوس الأعلى في الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل، ونعوذ بك اللهم من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. اللهم ارحمنا فوق الأرض وتحت الأرض ويوم العرض عليه، ويسر لنا الحج مرات ومرات يا رب العالمين. اللهم يسر لنا ويسر علينا الحج والعمرة يا حي وقيوم. اللهم يسر لنا ويسر علينا الحج والعمرة يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم، يسر لنا ويسر علينا الحج والعمرة يا حي وقيوم يا أرحم الراحمين، ويسر لنا أمورنا كلها، واحفظنا بما تحفظ به عبادك الصالحين. اللهم من مكر بنا فامكر به واجعل مكرهم يحيق بهم ويدمرهم تدميرا، واجعل مكر أولئك هو يبور، واجعل كيدهم في تضليل وتباب، واصرفهم وابعدهم وانقلهم مغزهم، وأرح العباد والبلاد والشجر والدواب منهم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم انصرنا ولا تنصر علينا، وأعنا ولا تعين علينا، وانصرنا على من بغى علينا. اللهم انصرنا على من بغى علينا، واكفنا المستهزئين، واصرف عنا كل مستهزئ يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم إنا نجعلك في نحورهم ونعوذ بالله من شرورهم. وصلي اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا، وجزانا وجزاكم الله خيرا، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.